Let's talk cancellations. Not the cancellations of people who are just canceling because of whatever the reason is. Let's talk. You send out notifications the night before that you're coming. You send out your 10, 15, 20 minute text on the way that you're coming. You pull in the driveway. Gates locked. What do you do? Well, our company policy is we text them. Well, obviously that we're on the way. We knock on the door. And we try to give them a call. I allow my scoopers to wait about 5 to 7 minutes. And then they text them and be like, hey, I've got to go on with the rest of my route. Please get with the office to reschedule. We thus having over 1,000 yards. We run 200 plus a day. Between 8 to 10 scoopers are out every day. We don't have time to be sitting and waiting. My scoopers hit around 4 to 4.5 an hour. 4 and 4.5 yards an hour. So the question is to charge them or not to charge them. So here's the thing. Everybody's going to have their own opinion on how they want to do it. In the beginning, I didn't charge them. But it was starting to get out of control. I mean, there was one point in time every week, 20 to maybe 30 to 40 people would cancel a week. That's a lot of money. I mean, that's one day's worth of a route you're losing. Well, you know, okay, things come up, things happen. I know the names. I know the habitual people that constantly cancel. Or those people that are always, the gates are always locked. In our service agreement that they agree and sign to, it states that if, you know, we've given you a text, you know, text and an email the night before the system, we use Jobber, it automatically sends it out 7 o'clock the night before that you're on the schedule. Okay, and then the next day, our scoopers, you know, within... Back in the day, it would have been like a 5 to 10 minute, but now they're sometimes they're like 2 minutes away. So sometimes I tell them, you know, look, if you're 2 minutes away, you know, send that text before you start the job that you're on and then go ahead and head to that job. So it gives them like 10 minutes. Because there's some of them they need to unlock the gate or some of them they got to put the dogs in. I get it. But what happens is we end up pulling in the driveway. And our guy sits there for 5 minutes. We never hear anything from him. So we have little... We went to Vista Print and got these little post-it notes made up. That just says, hey, sorry we missed you. Date, time, you know, gate locked, dogs out, and stuff like that. So we put those on the door and then we snap a photo and put it on the account that, you know, hey, we were here. It was locked. We furnish locks too. So we have locks that they can use free of charge while they're with us. So this shouldn't be a problem. We probably have 75 to 80 locks out. So there is a lot of locks. I mean, and we use word locks. Words are the ones with the numbers on them. We don't use key locks because there's so many different. The routes can change at any moment, you know, so it's just super hard. Our scoopers don't come to the office. They leave from their house. They only come to the office when they need to get supplies. So yes, back to the cancellation stuff. If it's like a one-off and it's just, you know, it just happens. Okay. We'll, you know, skip the ticket. We're in most areas 2 to 3 times a week, at least. So, what we try to do is, if they get back with us, you know, I'll tell them, hey, look, our next round is, you know, like a Monday would be a Thursday, a Tuesday would be a Friday. Wednesday's, yeah, it's kind of there. So, if they say, yeah, that's fine, come by Thursday, cool. We move over to Thursday, put them back in the route, and we get them. If it's a little more of a tricky situation... I don't scoop anymore. I handle overflow, call-ins, and then I'll go out. So most of the time, I don't have a route anymore. I'm majorly working from home and then working from the office and then managing the money. I don't make the money. I manage it. So if it needs to be like a random day that we're just not really close, my office manager, she'll... call me and be like, hey, can I put this on you on this day? This is when they said they can be there. And I'm like, well, what's going on? They tell me. I'm like, yeah, that's fine. But if it's a habitual person that this always happens, no, a skip ticket goes in for that value. I mean, because next week we're going to have 2 weeks worth of poop. It's not fair. It's not fair to the scooper or the company. Okay, you know, the scooper comes in, there's 2 weeks worth of poop. Now, my scoopers are paid hourly, but that eats into our labor. But I don't want them stressed out thinking, oh, crap, I got to get this yard done in the 7 to 10 minutes like it normally does. No, it's been 2 weeks. I expect you to take 15 minutes in there. So, do we charge it? Yes and no. If they message us the night before and they're not a habitual person, that they constantly cancel, then we'll just delete the ticket and that'll be fine. But if my scooper comes back and be like, yeah, you know, that one last week they skipped. And I'm like, yeah, they're like, yeah, I went there, man. There was like 2 weeks worth of poop in there. Well, now they're in our heads and we have a list of those people. And so next time they skip, we're going to verify why they skip. If they're skipping just because, hey, I'm not going to be able to get the gate unlocked or some silly, stupid reason. If the dogs weren't there, that's fine. I'm perfectly okay. I will not charge you if the dogs were not there. But 9 times out of 10, the dogs are there. So we do charge. Like I said, as your business grows to be as big, you know, kind of like where we're at now, you know, thinking about it, I think we maybe only have 5 people, maybe 5 a week that are like, hey, we've been on vacation all week, you know, no need to come out. Fine. And a lot of those people, they're honest and they know, you know, I'm like, I'm not going to be mad. You know, that's one less that we got to get to. I'm not going to send my guy out. But then again, people get mad because we will go out to a job, walk the entire yard, nothing in the back. So the instructions are, if it says the back, we go to the back, we don't find anything. Go check in the front, go check on the porch, go check other places. And we don't find anything. They're going to note it on the account that we didn't find anything. Well, when the bill comes through and they got billed for that week, some customers call us and they get mad. And they're like, well, we were on vacation and we messaged you. No, you didn't message me. You find which way you messaged me. Like, we've gotten to the point now, you have to prove that you messaged us. You know, you have to show the email, the text message, whatever it might be. And 9 times out of 10, they never come back with anything and they pay their bill. You know, I'm sorry you didn't message us. I'm sorry that, you know, you were on vacation. That's fine, you're on vacation, but I read my messages on vacation. Texts come in, I'm like, oh, crap, so-and-so's coming. Crap, I'm not home. I'm like, hey, cancel, abort, stop, you know. We're not there. You know, and I get it. We all go on vacation. But so I would definitely put it in your service agreement about cancellations. Because as you become a larger company, the cancellations is wasting your time, especially if you're going and driving to that job. You know, it's a pain in the rear when you're got in your GPS to go and you're halfway there and then boom, you get a text message. Well, you're driving. So you're not supposed to look at it. So you're endangering yourself or you're pulling over, wasting more time to read, oh, they want to cancel or they want to skip this week. You've already wasted all this time. What's your time worth to you? You know, as far as I'm concerned, if it's on that day, if you didn't message us before our scoopers left, in our service agreement, it states you must give a 24-hour notice. I have some people will tell me a week, 2 weeks. I have people that have told me, like, in August they're going on vacation, in which week they don't need us to scoop. I love it. Boom, we went to that date. Boom. Delete their ticket. Said and done. But then I have people who I have my scooper sitting at their house for 10 minutes at least because they've done pulled in, they've gotten out, they've gotten all their stuff ready, they went to the gate, the gate's locked. They went to go see if there was another gate. It's locked. They knocked on the door. No answer. They got on their phone, gave a phone call, went to voicemail. Shot them a text, be like, hey, I'm here at your house, you know, and now they're sitting and waiting. After 5 minutes, they've notified my office manager. And at that point, it goes on the list and we tell them to move on to the next one. You know, it's a business, not a charity. You know, as your business grows, you know, we've had some people who are like, yeah, Mondays aren't working for us. And the problem is Thursdays and Fridays, everybody wants Thursday and Friday. They get filled up quick. So your Thursdays and Fridays are just going to swell. But eventually a certain point in time, you have to do a cutoff. Like you just can't. You have to split that route. You're going to always be splitting routes in this industry. I mean, in any routing type thing for route density, you're going to be splitting routes. But then you're also going to be trying to wiggle around the stupid mowers out there. I had a customer cancel because the mowers were coming that day. What does that mean to me? Do you want it picked up or not? Because if you're going to cancel every time the mowers are out there, look, there's three companies in my town versus 2,000 mowers. Find you a different mowing company that mows on the day after we come. Because our routes are set and we get people all the time. Well, that day doesn't work for us. Okay. All right. We'll cancel your service agreement. Good luck. Have a good day. And we delete everything. So cancellation fees, yes, do them. I'm telling you. Because you're going to go back next week. And when you got 50 houses in 1 week that canceled last week, and you got to go back out, which by the time you get to that number, hopefully you'll have a few different people working for you. But you're going to find out you're going to have 2 weeks worth of poop in that yard. So you know, no matter how you're paying them, if you're paying your scooper per yard, you're paying your scooper a percentage, or you're paying your scoopers an hourly rate, you know, you want to make it fair to your scoopers. You have to take care of your employees. You have to take care of the people that are in the field when something like that happens. Now, yeah, granted, my scoopers get to sit for 10, 15 minutes on the clock and do nothing. In the summer months, I'm sure they enjoy it because they got the AC on full blast. I'm paying them to sit there to find out, to give this customer reasonable time to get back with us. And after a certain point, we have to move on. We can't be sitting. We have to move on. So I'll say it in this video if you made it this far. APALS.org. They're having their convention in the middle of September. Go to APALS.org and check it out if you're looking at something new. I mean, looking to start, or you're just new into this business. So I am going to get off here. Have a good day.